take my partner back if they cheated, like if we were married, because like, well, not even, even then I still might want a divorce, because if I'm married and we've got like kids
or man or whatever comes to you and say, oh yeah, I was drunk, you're if you're a girl that doesn't think this, like, oh, then you wanted to do it, like, that's
it's a glass, yeah, you have a glass. If you drop that glass and let's say it's broken, yeah, you can try as much times like to put it back together, but it's never gonna look the same. Guys, and today we are doing a group discussion. So let's start off by introducing everyone. So firstly,
my name is Tracy.
My name is Tata.
Say your name, man.
My name is Ian.
My name is Belle.
Abigail.
Aisha.
Forget that, Aisha. So what's the question?
No, I think people were asked to say we're not experienced like that. We're not old enough to know.
No, but wait, what's the question again?
If he or she cheats.
Nah, do that question first and do that other question after then. So the first question, would you take your partner back?
So would I take my partner back if he cheats? Depending on what it is, but to be honest, my mindset right now is saying no, because don't cheat. Like, what sort of relationship is that? I'm not condoning that. So no, for me it's no.
Also depends on the situation. Obviously, if I've been with a person for so long, but it also depends on what they cheated. Like, if they actually had like sexual intercourse with the person, I don't think they can. But if they were just like doing rubbish or whatever, or just messaging them and going to your house, it depends on the situation. But I don't think I would take them back. Or if I did take them back, like, I would actually be a nightmare. Like,
do you remember my example that I made?
What?
That one.
Oh no, but the thing is, I might take you back. Like, if it's like my boyfriend for like 2 years, I'll take you back, but I'll actually haunt your life. Like, I'll be evil, so you wouldn't want to go back with me. Something? Like, no, you actually wouldn't.
Ah, please.
Why is that
going?
Didn't you just go?
Yeah, I just said
something. Nah, she hasn't. Yeah.
With me, I would only take my partner back if they cheated, like if we were married, because like, well, not even, even then I still might want a divorce, because if I'm married and we've got like kids and stuff, then it's like I'm breaking.
Bible says a lot of things.
Exactly, but people are doing whatever they want to do. But
yeah, but if you cheat within marriage, the Bible says you can actually leave the marriage.
I know, but not so not even hard. Just that, because to me,
I
actually
agree with you as well.
It's always me that. Okay, but it's not even just about obviously it is about the Bible, but I'm saying, because if I have children and we're married, then it's like I'll be breaking up the whole, obviously you're the one that done the action, but I would be the one breaking up the whole family home. It'll be a selfish thing, so I'd probably consider divorce. But me and myself, I probably, because I didn't really have like a whole household family, and I really want that when I'm older for my kids, so I'd probably stay. But if we're boyfriend and girlfriend and stuff like that, we're not married, we don't have children, then I'm sorry, I'm cutting, because with me it's a whole disrespect thing. If you've cheated, you've disrespected me, you're going out making me look like some silly girl, you obviously don't care, like, I'm sorry, but I'd leave unless we're family.
I think I don't even agree with the whole depends what it is, because let's say it was something small like kissing. If you let that happen, then you're actually telling him that you're gonna let anything happen, because once he goes through that stage of he's kissing other girls and you take him back, he's gonna go, no, he's gonna then, okay, he's gonna, yeah, okay, he's gonna then go.
Yeah, not just and then
sorry, wait, let her talk.
Next time he's in a situation where he's like, he's about to kiss another girl, even though it's already happened with last time and you told him not to do it again and you take him back, he's gonna think, oh, maybe she's gonna say the exact same thing again, so I might as well just do it and take risks. If he's drunk, it doesn't even matter as well, because drunk people always remember what happened. Unless you get in a concussion or something, unless you, yeah, unless you, but if you're that type of drunk where you kiss someone, you can go home, sleep it off and wake up the next day, then you definitely remember what happened. So my whole point of it depends what it is does not run. If whatever little thing happens, I think it's better to stay safe and just leave, then keep saying, oh, I'm going to take him back. Then it progresses to a point that you really cannot take him back and, like, leave him. So it's better to leave him at the stage that you actually can than later on.
Do you know the thing we said about being drunk? Even if someone... No, but the thing is, if a boy is in a relationship or, like, if he's a married man and you actually let yourself get intoxicated to that point where you can't even remember what's happening, you're just moving completely mad and then cheating, then that's actually a personal problem. You shouldn't even let that happen. You shouldn't... You should have consideration of your wife or your girlfriend at home that you shouldn't get that drunk, that you'll be doing up madness.
Wife, you got a spy.
Why are you just doing up weird scenarios that's never gonna happen?
Yeah, that can happen.
If you get spiked, okay, I understand. But if it's like you,
if like your drink got spiked, so what is it, like me or the guy?
So
the
guy.
Okay, so the guy's like my guy's drink gets spiked. Quite silly, but anyways, yes, if his drink got spiked and somebody, like there's a witness, somebody said, oh, his drink got spiked, or maybe that person said, oh, I spiked his drink, something like that, you need to prove to me that you didn't drink alcohol, but it's like it wasn't you that took the alcohol, if that makes sense. Like if it got spiked, then it's like, okay, fair enough, you got drunk, you don't know what's going on. But if you know your how much alcohol you're consuming, how you're gonna get, like, you know how you act when you're around girls, especially when you're drunk, don't put yourself in that situation, because you know exactly what you're doing and you're coming to me saying, oh, I was drunk. But you knew when you get, you know when you get drunk and you're around girls, you act that way. So that's your own problem, that's not my problem.
The worst thing, this is why I definitely disagree about the whole drunk thing, would you take him back even if he done it when he was drunk? When you're drunk, you do the stuff that you really want to do. Like, you do the stuff that you're more like, oh, I might as well do it now because I'm drunk. You do them stuff. So if your boyfriend or man or whatever comes to you and say, oh yeah, I was drunk, you're if you're a girl that doesn't think this, like, oh, then you wanted to do it, like, that's even worse because you was drunk. Like, do you not get what I'm trying to say? So it's even worse, because if you were sober and he kissed the girl, then either way there would be a little bit of consideration. But drunk is when you literally do things that you don't care what other people are gonna say and you do it. So I don't care, that's not an excuse. If you're cheating when you're drunk, it's literally the worst. So you've been wanting to do it for ages.
And the thing is, if someone cheated on me and I got back with them, I would be too paranoid, and like I feel like I'd become like an annoying girlfriend, because I'll just be like, every time you're going out, I'll think, exactly, there'll be no trust there, because that's done, that's out the window. So I'd be like, oh, okay, if you're getting out, who are you going with, who's going to be there, what time are you getting back? And I don't want to be that type of girlfriend. Like, I'm the type of person, I want to be your friend, I want us to be cool, but if you've gone and cheated on me, then I'm going to be moving.
Exactly. You'll become insecure about it.
Yeah, exactly. I'll become insecure and paranoid, because if you've done it once, I don't know you're not going to do it again. Yeah. But obviously, if I've decided, let me give you a second chance, because maybe I think, okay, me and you have got something good going on, but I'll still be scared, because the same reason why you may have gone and cheated before, you might feel the same way again.
It's like, so let's use this. There's a glass here, you have a glass. If you drop that glass, and that, so it's broken, yeah, you can try as much times like to put it back together, but it's never gonna look the same. So that's the same as a relationship. If you cheat, if you I don't know, if you just abuse the relationship, like the relationship is just really bad, like you keep breaking that person, do you ever think the person's gonna be the same? No. Like, how can you come and cheat on me? And like, first of all, it takes a lot for a relationship. You've cheated on me, that's my trust gone for you. That alone, the relationship is not going well. It's full stop. You have to, no, because the thing is, yeah, with me, I'm a bit weird. Like, I believe in second chances. Like, everybody deserves a second chance. But it's just that, like, if I give you a second chance and you cheat again, this time I won't blame you, I'll blame myself. I'll be like, okay, that's my fault, because I allowed you to do that to me again. That's the trust gone. Me, Trust is one thing. How can you have a relationship without trust?
Exactly.
You're always going to be paranoid. The girl's going to seem insecure when she really isn't secure. Exactly. I could be a very secure girl, but because of the trust that you made me, like, we've, that is broken between us, it's always going to be, I'm not insecure because of that. It's just simply, I do not trust you because I gave you the trust before and you broke it. So it's simple as that. Yeah, it's not insecurity though. It's not, insecurity. So can I turn around and like no, it's not insecure. It's not an insecurity. I've given you a chance and then you're coming to also do it again. No. It's not insecurity
because insecurity is not like being secure about yourself. So thinking, oh yeah, he doesn't like, he's cheating because I'm fat, or he's cheating because this. No, it's cheating because he, it's cheating because he's the one who's doing the madness.
I get what you mean, but you insecurity where, let's say that she took a Mac, and then as soon as she takes a Mac, and then he's doing stuff, she's gonna start thinking, oh yeah, is my appearance, is obviously my body type and all of that. But there's two different. If it's that, then that's way off. I don't think any girl should even be doing that. But if it's a situation where you're blaming yourself because you allowed it, it's not insecurity. It's literally. Okay, my second point is. No, but no, not a second point.
Because I'm adding on to what you just said.
Wait,
just
yeah, but I. Okay, yeah.
What I was saying, along with like what you were saying. Okay. Along with what you were saying. What's it called? Like the whole thing with insecurity. I'm not gonna lie, it does sort of make you feel a little bit insecure. So let's like, for example, you've like you've cheated on me with another girl. Yeah, she's probably, I don't know, maybe to me automatically, girls, we all have insecurities. But if you go and cheat on someone, automatically I'm gonna think, ah, what's wrong with me that has made you cheat? If that makes sense, like, what have I, like, it, I'm not gonna lie, the girl's always gonna think about it, like, take it personal, like, what have I done to make him go to another girl to get that, if that makes sense. But then again, after, get yourself together. Is the boy, is your own problem. Maybe the boy's insecure. Sometimes some boys cheat because they think that they're not good enough for their girl, even though that's not an excuse. But some boys do that. Some boys are insecure, that's why they cheat, because they feel like if they can get attention from many girls, then all of a sudden they're secure. But that, the fact that you can't accept love from one girl, if you're insecure, it's not me, you're insecure. That's what it is. That's insecure boys. Sort yourself out.
Okay, Daniel, there's a camera on me because another reason, another point is like, if you're cheating and you keep taking the mat, there's gonna be like, you're gonna think, oh, your man is respecting you every time that you go back to him. Like, you as a girl is gonna think, oh, he accepted the fact that I took him back, he's gonna appreciate me more, da da da. He's not gonna appreciate you, because the more and more you keep taking him back, the more the boy would not actually want you. This is how boys want. Like, boys will tell you that they want you to take him back, but really deep down they don't want you to take them back. So it's gonna be a thing where he won't actually respect you. And when you're not respected by your own boy, what girl is gonna respect you? So the cheating is just gonna become more, because when another girl sees you getting disrespected by a boy, they're not gonna care if, like, their friend, so let's say a girl's friend goes and, let's say, beat a girl that they know they're in a relationship. This is why I think many girls do it. Many girls like going for other people's man now because the boy don't respect them. So the girl's gonna think, oh, do you know what, I might as well do my thing and let me get in the way, then, oh, let me just not leave it and let me see her, like other girls doing it. So either way, the more that you take him back, the more you're actually gonna get disrespected. So there's no way of you cheating and the relationship is gonna go from, it's gonna go better. So personally, I think if a boy cheats and he cheats, then the relationship will never get better again, because the girl is also gonna now be like, oh, she's not gonna really have insecurities or anything, but it's gonna be a situation where, like, she's gonna get more, there's gonna be girls, yeah, because for, let's say me, if I was getting cheated or did her, I'm that girl that, because you can get a girl that, like, she loses all her, what's that word, not even self-respect, like, nah, not even self, nah, it's motivation. So you can get a girl that you keep listen, not even that, like, motivation, dedication and all that. So if so if you go and tell the girl, oh yeah, I cheated, there's gonna be like, yeah, okay, she's gonna keep allowing it to happen. But personally, you think that she's happy at the fact that she's taking you back and all that. Your girl could be sat there right now and saying, do you know what? I'm actually calculating the amount of times you cheat on me, because there's getting a point where I actually really don't care now, but I'm not leaving because I don't want to leave yet.
Wait, nah, this is kind of a question. But when you man talk about cheating, do you mean emotional cheating or actually cheating, going cheating, out? Because if you mean, like, emotional cheating, like, emotional cheating, yeah, it's like you, the boy may not, like, have, like, do stuff with the girl, but he'll still, like, be messaging her, going to her house, talking to her, watching movies. Because I feel that is even worse, because when they just have sex with other girls, that's just them being, like, stupid. But when they actually emotionally, like, love this other girl, I think it's more, like, it hurts more and stuff. So, you don't even know what emotional cheating was.
Yo, what's up, guys? Daddy TV, and obviously I'm back with another video. Now, obviously, right now I want to say subscribe, like, more public videos are coming very, very soon. You feel me? Obviously, I thank you guys. I don't know if when I'm uploading this for 1,000 subscribers, but if we are, I thank you very much. If we're not, we love everybody that subscribes to us and helps and supports our channel. You hear me? Let's help us grow. Like, with your help, we can get way more over than 1,000. Like, rah. You hear me? Obviously, subscribe. Peace.